It's easy to add and edit images, shapes, and backgrounds in Avery Design and Print Online. To get started, choose your Avery product, which can be found on your product package and a design template. The steps are basically the same across products and pre-designed templates, but I'm using a blank template for Avery 22807 round labels for this tutorial. For this project, I'm going to create one design for all of my labels, so you'll notice that I have Edit All selected on the customize screen. To add an image to a project, start with the Image tool on the left. Click Add Image, and then you can see all the options for where images can be selected. To select an image file saved on your computer, use the First button to browse for your image. There is also a gallery of images available within Avery Design and Print. You can also save images to your Avery account where you can access later. There is also an option to use images from your social media accounts. At this time, Avery Design and Print supports Facebook, Instagram, Flickr, and Google Photos. For this demo, I'm just going to select an image from the Avery gallery. Use the categories on the left to see particular designs. The Borders and Frame section has some decorative borders, but if you just want a plain border, then it's easier to add a shape, which I'll show later in this video. Hover your mouse over the image you want, and then click the green Select button to add it to your project. To resize the image, use the white circles on the corners or sides. If you want the image to be shorter or taller, you will need to uncheck the lock aspect ratio setting on the left. To move the image, just click and drag with your mouse to where you want it or click on it and use the arrow keys on your keyboard. Be sure your image stays inside the safety line to keep it from getting cut off. If you have a print to the edge Avery product, there are dotted lines at the outer edge of the template that you can stretch it to. Or you can use the Set as Background button on the left. To rotate your image, hover your cursor over the blue lollipop at the top, and then click and drag to the left or right. If you want to replace an image that's on the template, select the image, then use the Replace Image option on the left. Note that it will stretch the new image to match the size of the original image. If you want to avoid that, just delete the first image and add a new image. If you want to crop your image, select the image, then click Crop Image on the left. Click and drag the crop lines, then click outside of the image and it will update. If you want to undo the crop, use the button at the top of the screen. To add transparency to your image, use the slider control on the left. To change a color in the image, use the buttons at the bottom of the image menu on the left. Click on the image, then on Change Color. You can choose from some pre-selected swatches or click to choose from the color wheel. Once you select the color, your cursor will change to a paint bucket and you can click on the part of the image you want to replace. It will replace everything in the image that shares that color. If you have a specific hex color code, you can also enter that, but please remember that printers produce colors differently than what you see on your screen. If there's a color in the template that you'd like to match, click Select Color from Image and your cursor will turn into an eyedropper. Then, click the color you want to match and the cursor will turn into a paint bucket. Then, you can click on the color you want to update. If you want to remove a color from your image, select the image and then click Remove Color. Your cursor will turn into a paint bucket and you can click on the color you want to remove. To change the background color, there's a tool at the top of the screen that will add a solid color to the entire design template. Select a color, then click Apply, and you will see the background option. To change the color, just click again at the top. If you want to add different colors to each label or card on the sheet, you can use the Shapes tool. The Shapes tool can be found under More on the left side menu. Click Shape, then add shape to choose from a few different categories including basic, arrows, math, and more. Click Apply to make your selection. To change the size, use the white circles at the edges. To print all the way to the edge of your label, extend your shape to the outer dotted lines. When your shape is where you want it, you can change the color and click Apply. This same process works for the border of the shape. Just use the Outline tool on the left. Be careful with exact borders, as your printer may not be able to exactly hit the edges of your label or card. We recommend thicker borders and using the advanced printer settings for labels or cards and best quality to help your printer pull the sheets through more accurately. Please note that when you add a shape, it will be the top layer of your project. To use a shape as your background, click on the shape and use the Arrange tool at the top to send it to the back. You can also arrange layers using the object list under the Navigator. To change the background color for individual labels, select Edit 1 in the Navigator on the right. Then, use the arrows or click the next label you want to change. The orange outline will indicate which label has been selected for editing. Click on the shape and update the fill color and/or the outline using the tools on the left. Changes can be applied to each label or card in your project. When you're happy with your labels, click Preview and Print to move forward. If you need more help, visit avery.com/help for more information and to contact our care team. Thank you for using genuine Avery products.